A career in science academia is grand and prestigious. You walk in hallowed halls, work with the best minds, in white lab coats, solving the most complex and important problems of our day. You do lots of research, and then one day, you'll become a professor with a leather-bound seat, oak-paneled office, lots of books, lots of money, and an important body of life-changing work. Wake up, guys! Sadly, it doesn't always happen like this. In fact, it very rarely does. See, the complicated and frankly crappy path to becoming a scientist is forcing many of the best people out of science. And who's the first to go? Yep, women, minorities, and low socioeconomic groups. Which is why science looks like this. Old white dudes.
But how did it get to be this way? Isn't science supposed to be about the search for truth, regardless of who you are or where you've come from?
Well, no. See, most people who pursue a PhD in science do so with the intent of actually getting a job in academia, specifically as a faculty member. But in nearly all STEM-related fields, you can't get a faculty-led position at a university without doing postdoctorate work. What is postdoc work? Well, it's research that you do after your doctorate, hence the name, postdoc. Postdoc work is essentially like doing a scientific apprenticeship, or as Drake would say, starting from the bottom. Universities who hire postdoc researchers often use them as grunts. They're the ones actually conducting the experiments, recording data, and dealing with all the boring and tedious parts of being a scientist. Along with grad students, postdocs are often the primary authors on many studies. But postdoc work is extremely low paying, considering you've just spent 10 years getting a damn PhD. Salaries are often paid as stipends, with the amount set by NIH's National Research Service Award. And they start at around $43,000, which is roughly $10,000 less than you'd make as a store manager for McDonald's. But at least McDonald's store managers get health benefits. Postdocs are often paid as contractors, hired on for 1 to 3 years at a time, which means they don't get benefits and their jobs aren't secure. Obviously, the aim is to get a more secure, well-paying faculty position after a postdoc, but because universities are handing out more PhDs than there are faculty jobs, researchers often have to move around from postdoc to postdoc for 10 years or more. And all these years pipetting chemicals and recording data doesn't really provide you with many real-world skills that would be useful if you wanted to leave the science world. So many promising scientists are trapped in this cycle of low-paying, insecure, menial work, despite having 10 years of college and college debt behind them. And this is all happening right around the time that they're in their late 20s and early 30s, right about the same time that they're trying to start a family or buy a house. But they can't, because their job means that they have to move to a completely new city at the end of the year at their own expense. And the postdoc system is actually affecting the scientists themselves. A study from the University of California, Berkeley, showed that almost half of science PhD students were clinically depressed, citing factors like career prospects, living conditions, and financial confidence as sources of concern. And as mentioned, it keeps the white, wealthy male status quo in science academia, because women, particularly women from minorities or low socioeconomic backgrounds, are often forced to leave the postdoc world if they want to have a family because there's no maternity leave and not enough money to cover the basic cost of having children.
Okay, so postdocs are bad for early career scientists, but how does the postdoc program impact science itself?
For starters, the length of these postdocs might not be enough for these researchers to do their best work. They need to publish in order to secure a permanent science job, and they're going to need to publish before their 2 or 3 year contract is up, so chop chop. Second, by rigging the system this way and undervaluing hard work, the smart entrepreneurial minds, the ones that can solve complex real-world science problems, are quickly discovering that work is bad and the pay is shit and their future prospects are limited, and they take their skills elsewhere, places where they're better remunerated and can advance their careers more quickly, i.e. they leave academia to work in the commercial job market.
So if we want to capture these young, passionate, problem-solving minds and keep them in the future of science, postdocs need a better situation. But how do we do that?
That's where you guys come in. What do you think? How can we get better conditions for postdocs, the backbone of the future scientific research? Should the government give out more money so that there's more money available to pay these postdocs? Or should universities be limiting the amount of postdocs that they have working so that the ones that are working can all have better conditions? Or should we end PhDs altogether or change them in some way? Let us know your solutions in the comments below.
Hi everyone, I'm Jade Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching ScIQ, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.